Right then guys, hope everyone's good. Welcome back to the YouTube channel. We've got Joe behind the camera today from ContentConnx. So first video with Joe for a little while. I have actually ran through this session on YouTube pretty recently. So we're not gonna go through sort of every single exercise and why we're doing what we're doing. What I wanted to cover was sort of how we're trying to standardize everything that we're doing. So it seems to be like a bit of a buzzword at the minute. Everyone's going on about standardization, but I think it's an important topic to cover and why you need to focus on standardising everything that you're doing to actually track progress properly. Me and Reese have slightly different sessions today, so my pressing is the hammer strength flat press and then the
Sterling
shoulder press. Reese is doing two different presses.
Why are you doing different presses today?
I don't break down when I do dumbbells, so high incline dumbbells in first and then the light fitness incline press second.
I tried doing dumbbells for like 2 weeks after my show and just battered me, so I'm going to stick on machines for a little bit longer, and then when I feel like I've got a bit more body fat to be able to do some dumbbell pressing, I'll jump back in. But yeah, that's pretty much everything guys, so we'll just do a bit of an edit and odd bits throughout the session. I'll chat about sort of how we're trying to standardise everything. Thank you.
Hybrid, eccentric. Come on, stay on it.
Yeah.
Oh.
What's that one?
Oh. Felt heavy.
Move on.
Felt fine, like then. We get to like 5, 6, 7.
Yeah.
So guys, obviously like the main topic of the video is on how we're trying to standardize everything that we're doing. So first movement was the lateral raise machine, and you'll have seen what we were doing was pausing in both ends of the rep. So that's something that I'll sort of make sure that clients are doing, that I focus on doing, is pausing in different portions to just stay strict with it. You know, if you tell yourself 1 second pause in both ends of the rep and stay strict with that every single rep, you know that every rep is perfect, and you know that when you do progress that it's accurate progression. So 1 second pause at the bottom, driving it out. When I get the rep short, 1 second pause at the top, just to keep it strict and standardise every single rep that we're doing. Then we moved on to the hammer strength flat press. To be fair, form can still improve on that. It's a little bit quick, a little bit rushed on the eccentrics. But another thing in terms of standardisation is your tempo. So on that, I'm trying to think sort of 2-3 second eccentric, power out the hole. Dependent on the load and the set, I may need longer in that contracted position on that lockout just to reset, air in, brace and go again. But generally, trying to focus on a nice 2-3 second eccentric every rep on the compound movements. Next movement is the sterling shoulder press. So very similar to the hammer strength in terms of what we're trying to think to standardize it. So 2-3 second eccentric, making sure that depth is spot on every rep, and then not letting sort of the tempo or the range of motion slip throughout the whole set.
Good, stay on it now, don't drop. There we go.
Thank you.
way that I was trying to standardise that was to tap at the bottom of every rep. So making sure that it's not the bounce, trying to clean it off to a few reps where I'm bouncing out the bottom. So that's something to work on. But the reason that I'm tapping is again so I can standardise the depth and I know that every single rep is the exact same. Then we moved on to the Panatta T-bar row, which is a really nice movement. Generally a little bit tougher on the erectors than a normal T-bar because you're sort of standing over it a bit more. But a very good movement. Trying to keep my chest on the pad, trying to not let sort of my sternum come off the pad. That's a form of standardisation. And then we did a top set and then we did a cluster set at the back off. One other sort of reason that we'll sort of film our sets is to focus on standardisation as well. So I'd always recommend filming your sets just to watch back over, you know, week by week. And you can see if you're progressing in terms of numbers and reps and load, or you watch back over your form week on week on week and you realise that it's just getting worse and worse, you know that you're not accurately progressing. So you know, film your sets. Don't be afraid to drop your phone up in the gym and film your sets so that you can watch back and make sure that they're all standardised reps. And then we've just finished on the chest supported pull down. So with that, the first set, we spent more time in the contraction. So the lats are still a little bit fresher, obviously, on that first set. And when we go on to the second set, when the lats are a bit more fatigued, we're spending more time in a lengthened range. And then we finish off with a stretch as well, just to fatigue the lats in that isometric hold. And also to get the benefit of like an added stretch in terms of recovery and a bit of mobility work as well. Usually, I would do a hanging stretch at the end of a session. So I would do like a hanging leg raise to get that benefit of the stretch and sort of the added benefit of the stretch on the back, but today I don't have abs at the end, so we just add it after lats. To finish off now, we've got a little bit of pecs, rear delts, and then arms to finish. Sometimes I love you way too much. We'll be right back. Right then guys, so we finished off with the pec deck. So the way that we were trying to standardise that was with like a 2 second pause in the stretch and a 2 second pause in the contraction. Really focused on like scooping the elbows together and getting the humerus across the midline of the body. Then we went on to the rear delts, again pausing in both ends, sort of a couple of seconds in there in a lengthened range, aiming for a 1 second on the contraction, really focused on keeping shoulders forward. And then just finished off with a bit of arms. So again, with the arms, I was tapping at the bottom of every rep on the bicep curl to make sure that I know I'm getting the exact same sort of lengthened range and aim for a 1 second contraction every rep. Tempos are always 3-4 seconds down and never, just it's getting hard towards the end, I'm not just dropping it and reducing the range. Triceps, spending as much time sort of in the stretch as I can towards the end of the session when triceps are pretty fatigued from the presses anyway. So just spending a little bit longer in the stretch, about 3 seconds there, 1 second contraction, control nice and slow. What you'll notice is like throughout the whole set, the form doesn't slip. So this is something that I'm trying to get across to my clients all the time, is that regardless of the rep, whether it's rep one or the last rep, they should look the same. The only difference should be that that last rep, the concentric is slower, or as the set goes on, the concentric becomes slower and slower and slower because the set obviously becomes harder and the muscle becomes more fatigued. So let's say the bicep curls, I've just done it. The first rep might look like that. Control nice and slow, pausing the stretch. The last rep, I don't rush anything, change anything, I don't rush on the eccentric or anything like that. I keep the pause, but the concentric, as much as I'm giving it the same as the first rep, it looks like this. And even on the last one, I was actually forcing with this hand to give a force rep. So don't rush, don't panic when the set gets hard and it starts to burn. Go until the muscle cannot do the weight anymore. That's something I'm trying to get across to my clients a lot. So in terms of ways to standardise, which is obviously, like I said at the beginning, sort of the topic of this video, focus on your tempos, make sure your tempo doesn't change. So generally a good tempo would be about 3 seconds on an eccentric and 1 second on a concentric. Add pauses to the lengthened and the shortened range to keep it strict. So like we did on the lateral raise, 1 second here, 1 second here, like we did on most of the things, but adding a slight pause to keep it strict and to stay in control of the weight. And just stay calm, don't panic, don't rush when the weight and the set gets harder. Okay guys, but I'll leave the video there, so any questions on any of that or any issues wanting to ask about how to standardise things, please feel free. Hope you all enjoyed the video, and thanks again to Joe for filming, and I will see you all in the next one.